Hello and welcome to another one of my videos. In this one, it's time to put a generator together. Let's do it from the beginning.
Now, the size of everything is going to be dictated by the car inner tube that you use. Going square with the inside and the outside, I'm going to mark it like this and go about an inch wide, 2 or 3 centimeters wide, and cut that with a pair of scissors. So now I can find out what sized piece of plywood I'm going to use, because it's got to basically go around a pulley and then another pulley that has a broomstick on. So it's going to have to go around one and with the other inside there. That's with room enough for a couple motors, one or two motors, which are going to be the generators. And that will dictate how big my board is going to be. So in the end, you're going to get something like this, the belt around there with a little bit of stretch there, with the larger pulley like that, and the smaller one with its groove, both with their axles, with your nails and stuff like that. Check out earlier videos in this playlist to see how to manufacture those. Now we're going to have two boards, one for each side, and we're going to have the small pulley and enough room for two motors, and we're going to have some posts, some sticks, to separate the two boards, the width more or less of what you've decided, enough room for the pulley and the belt, and just a millimeter or two on each side for slack. And there's going to be the four corner posts, all of the same length, and two in the center. So that's going to go there, and that one there. I'm going to put a little bit of glue on there and then nail those from the other side, all six of them. Next, taking into account some space for your motor and your other pulley, we're going to put drill a hole right in the center through both of those boards, both at the same time. Now, on a piece of tin, in this case from an old computer power supply, I'm going to cut some little squares with some little ears like that, and punch a hole through the middle. Then I'm going to place that over the hole and mark the four little corners here so that I can see where I'm going to cut a couple slots in the wood there. Then I will bend over those tabs and put them down the slots. Now, on a block, I'm going to just put that on there and bend them over, flatten them over with a hammer. From this side, I'm going to make just a bit of a dent or a hole so that I can find it on the other side to punch it back the other way. So now, repeat the process on the other hole on the other side, but on the inside. So when that's in there, it should spin nice and freely. Next is to put the larger pulley in there. I'm going to find the center and make a groove because it's going to adjust up and down. But I think I'll put the broom handle through a hole that way. So I need to make the hole as wide as the broom handle. Use a knife or a saw. And on the other board, we're going to cut a groove just the width of the axle down the middle. so it is able to slide up and down. Now we will need an adjustment plate. We're going to split that, but we're going to need a hole there that the axle is going to go in, and that is going to slide up and down to adjust it. So it's a hole through both of those boards in the same place, and a larger hole for the broom handle through just one of them. So that goes on top of that large groove with the large hole. I've cut the two sides off this piece of board, and I'm going to glue them on with glue so that that will be able to slide up and down without wobbling sideways. With the other one, I'm going to do the same with this hole. I'm going to split the two sides off so that it will make a runner, and also put a bearing over that hole so it will slide up and down over the groove. So there we have it. I even put a few little nails just to help stick that on, and that can move up and down now. All right, so we're going to assemble it so we can adjust the belt strength. Put it together like that, that through the hole, the other one into its bearing, that one there on top of there, then the lid with the bearing into the other. Then we're going to screw it down with 6 screws to put the lid on so we can adjust that belt tension. So there we have it. And to be able to adjust that belt, make sure those boards are in their slots. And then with a couple of clamps, you can then raise that pulley until the belt is tight, and adjust both, one on one side, one on the other, so that you can get it balanced so that it will run clean. Could probably do with a bit more adjusting and get it so that it's running smooth. And when you have it where you want it, put a small screw in to hold it. And if the belt goes loose later on, adjust it and put the screw in a different place. So there it is, spinning quite happily. It's a good idea to take a piece of PVC pipe and put it on that axle there to stop it going in and out that way, just as a spacer. So it will go on like that. So now the generators, depending on what motor you have, for example something like this, I've made a little bracket in wood. On the top here at the small pulley end, I'm going to make a lid of board, screw it on with a couple of screws there eventually, and that motor there, which is going to be the generator, can screw to that lid with a couple of screws so that it will sit down in there at the right level. If you're going to use two, you might want to do this and make a bracket like that for two motors, one for each side, and screw it to that base so that it will go in to the right depth also. That is so that the rubber band can now go around this pulley to that one, and then reassemble everything. So if I connect a crank handle on it, tidy it up a little bit, connect some LEDs, LEDs, and then we have about 10 of them going quite happily. So there it is, functioning.